Yo, what's up guys, my name is Mr. Freeze 2244 and this is going to be a more of a reminder and a bit of some tips and tricks you can do for the Stowaway. Well, not tricks really, but some tips you can get for it. So the Stowaway Elusive Target is coming tomorrow on Friday the 19th of March. He's going to be available for 10 days. So he's going to be taking place in Isle of Scale in the Hitman 2 missions. So you would need the Hitman 2 access pass in Hitman 3 to access it. You won't be able to access it within Hitman 2. But upon completing this elusive target, you will get this tuxedo, mask and gloves suit as well. So you can use it on any other map overall. And getting a silent assassin is going to give you a contribution towards unlocking more suits for elusive targets. So the starting locations I recommend unlocking for Isle of Scale is getting to mastery level 15 to unlock the gallery starting location. I'm not completely certain if this is locked or not in the elusive target, I'm not completely sure. But this one in particular, the Architect's Lounge starting location, is a very powerful outfit to have on your... It's one of the best disguises you can have on the map. So I would highly recommend unlocking this to a mastery level 18. But it's not completely necessary, but it would make it a lot easier for you. The other items I would recommend unlocking to help you with the elusive target is if you have Haven Island, I would highly recommend getting to mastery level 10 to unlock the Seeker 1 Emetic Tranquilizer. By shooting it, it will make your targets sick and go to the bathroom to puke up. Another item I would recommend is the level 5 mastery level in Haven Island as well, the Remote Emetic Gas Device. As you can see, if you use this in a briefcase, you could explode it next to anybody and you'll get away with it. It's a complete silent assassin. Again, it will cause the same effects of making him sick, and it will go to the bathroom and so on and so on. So the target is going to be around this lounge area. Again, I'm not sure if this location is locked in the elusive target contract. There are some subtle map changes as well. Like, there's a waiter over here by the door and he was cleaning up a bunch of mess that's on the floor. Not this door, but the door over there. There you go. Over that one. But yeah, there is some subtle map changes, and I'll explain that in a second. But he will hang around these areas here, looking at the gramophone and etc. etc. So there's limited opportunities to actually get him around this area. I mean, if you're stealthy enough, you can shoot him from long range with a seeker to make him sick. But eventually, he does come into this bathroom anyway. But if you don't get in here quickly, the door will lock behind you. So just keep that in mind as well. Also, there's a subtle change for this bathroom. The crate is removed in the elusive target, if I remember correctly, and they put a screen there next to where the towels are, because he changes into the the blue disguise, so he's allowed access upstairs, and he will go up there. So if he doesn't go into that bathroom, he will come up here, up these stairs, and go into a different room to change, and it can be random as well when that happens. So I'm not completely sure if there's a specific trigger to make him come up here. But he will either go into that bathroom or come into this room. And again, it's the same situation where if you don't follow him in immediately, the door will lock behind him. Obviously, you can't use a lockpick in front of everybody, so you'll have to just wait for him to come out. And there's nowhere to hide his body in here. There's no crates or anything like that, unfortunately. But if you want a decent disguise upstairs or you're too late, you can come back through this room, climb up this pipe right here, and get access to this area just above. And this is where he's going to be. Is it the Architect's Lounge or something like that? Can't remember what it's called now. But if you want to get a nice disguise, you can basically just turn off this fuse box, turn it back on, and it will attract the waiter that's in there, the barman. Or alternatively, just open the door and throw a coin to get the Elite Guard disguise. The Elite Guard is the best disguise in the map, I think. And yeah, it will allow you complete access to this floor. Either disguise is good enough for it anyway. But I think when it comes to around this area, I reckon you should have been taking this target out before you even get to any of this part. But just again, I'm making you sure you're nice and prepared for all this stuff so you know exactly what to do. So if you want to get rid of this body, I think someone comes out here to smoke. Not 100% sure on that. But a good way to hide the body is basically try and not dump him, because you can't dump him anyway, but try and like drag him in a way where you can make him fall down there. Like if he doesn't complete the dump animation, no like person will die from drops. Don't know if anyone realized that. But yeah, you can just drop him down there. No one goes around that area anyway. At least I don't think so anyway. But yeah. Also, something I didn't notice as well is they've locked this door now. I didn't know they did that. Like, that wasn't a thing in Hitman 2, if I remember correctly. Correct me if I'm wrong in the comments, but I'm pretty sure that door was always locked. But he drops the key anyway. And if you're obviously going to bring a lockpick, so would highly recommend that. But yeah, if he's if you were too late to get him downstairs, he will hover around this area as well. Again, it's just a little bit difficult, more difficult to isolate and hop here. There's cameras everywhere as well, so you need to watch out for those. Because if you do get spotted by cameras on this map, the evidence is quite difficult to get to. Because it's in the security room right here, and you'd need a swipe card to get in. There's another location by the helipad, but it's a bit, you know, it's a bit difficult to get to. But overall, those are my little tips and little, you know, pieces of information that could be useful to you in the tomorrow's Elusive Target. I will be covering the a proper Silent Assassin guide for it anyway. At least one or two strategies, I think. But I'll try and get that out for tomorrow as quick as I possibly can. And yeah, so if you do need any extra additional help, you can go check out that video. Also, I'll leave the link in the description of the video I've done in Hitman 2 based on this Elusive Target, so you can get some pointers from that as well if you want to. I'll leave that link to that video in the description if you can check that out. So again, thank you very much for watching. Hopefully you've learned something from this, and yeah, let me know if I should do more of these in the future. And I'll see you guys in tomorrow's video. I'll see you there. Cheers. Good luck.